Hi, it's John. Now, most of my friends are people that have decided to sort of befriend me rather than me deciding to befriend them. It is a mutual thing in some ways, but a lot of people who say I might like to befriend, they're either too busy or you know, they just wouldn't want to associate with me. And that's fine. I mean, that's life, isn't it? I mean, I'll befriend more or less anybody, once they've betrayed me or tricked me, no, that's not quite the same then. You know, no, they may be an associate, but I would never sort of befriend them, as it were, if they play tricks on me. No, that's out then, really. Well, I will forgive, you know, but I'll be cautious. Sometimes I've had people befriend me, and I've no idea why. You know, sometimes, you know, possibly they might befriend because the status, they think I've got a bit of status or something, or something like that. But sometimes, they might think I'm more intelligent than them or have some skill that they want. But sometimes people befriend me and I have no idea why at all. And it might develop into quite a friendship. And you know, you never really quite understand why. But that going on from that, I mean, a lot of people do base the people they are prepared to befriend on if they can get something from them. If they're more educated. I mean, my father's very much like that. He's very keen on intellect. He thinks some people are brighter and some aren't. And I've moved from the unbright to the bright, luckily. I don't know. I certainly have a lot of things I can do for him now because he's registered blind. Yes, he's certainly... We have quite a different relationship to when I was, when I was a lot younger. When I was younger, so my father is sort of my friend now, which is great, because I mean, you know, that's what you always want, isn't it? Your father to be your friend. Basically because I can offer him things which he can't do. I can drive. He can't drive anymore because he's blind. Things like that, and he has difficulty filling in forms. I can do that, but it'd be nice to. It is more than that, isn't it? It is more than that, but that's sort of quite a lot of it. And I rather resent people who are like that. Well, I don't resent my father, but I resent people who will only befriend people who they can get something from. I can't mend my car. This person can mend my car. I'll befriend him. He might mend my car for me for free. You know, that I don't like. When you are a couple, I mean, you can run into problems because you can have a friend. Say Helen has a friend, and they want to bring them home, like, and have a meal. Say. And gradually you can work out, this friend likes Helen, but she doesn't like me. And they sort of start sort of driving a rift. And and that's bad, isn't it? You know, so, if you're married to somebody, then you have to befriend the couple. An outsider has to befriend the couple if they want to be friends with one. They can't start driving a rift. I mean, that's what marriage is about, isn't it? You know, it's about two becoming one, as the Spice Girls said. I can think of two men friends that I've got that instantly we met on courses, I think it was. You know that you're going to be friends, you know, because there's such sort of like-mindedness or similarities or something, and you just know. And I mean, that's fantastic. And And both of these friends, I mean, they liked Helen as well, so that worked out well. And I suppose more than that, actually, it could be three or four friends have been like that. And you just sort of, you know, after a couple of conversations, you just know that you're on the same wavelength, and you're going to be friends for a very long time. And that's fantastic. What has inspired this video is previous videos, but also I've been thinking about the Beatles lyric, "And in the end, the love you make is equal to the love you take." Was it John Lennon who wrote that? I think it could have been, or George Harrison. Certainly, probably wasn't Paul. I've been thinking about the Beatles. My favourite Beatle was always John Lennon. Troubled soul, philosophical problem maker, naive, incredibly naive, thought there were simple answers to the world. Happy birthday, war is over, you know, all this sort of thing. Make love, not war, you know, simple answers. Anyway, John was my favourite one. I don't think he was that much of a musician, was he? Not much of a lyricist, really, was he? Just a sort of Che Guevara-type character, sort of deep thinker and troubled soul and troubled childhood. I think George Harrison was quite a genius, wasn't he, on the guitar. Ringo was fantastic, fantastic drummer. Is it Charlie Watts in the Rolling Stones, a bit like him, you know, the solid man, you know. Paul McCartney, yeah, bass player. Anybody can play the bass, can't they? But Paul McCartney is the one, isn't he? I mean, I've been doing quite a bit. I've watched a whole sort of hour YouTube about Wings, and you know, it can be easy to think of Paul McCartney as a very superficial sort of person. But he is the genius. He really is. The amount of music he's made and the sort of simplicity of some... No, I don't even say the simplicity. The way he makes it look simple. Yeah. And he doesn't want to be... he doesn't want to be high and mighty. You know, he wants to... I can see the cat now. He wants to be the man who plays down the pub, and he doesn't want to be well, he is Sir Paul McCartney, but he doesn't want all that nonsense. Yeah. Anyway, bye for now.